disconnect the battery, you need to flip the unit over and take out all of the bottom cover screws. And then you can flip the unit over and open it up. Now you can use your spudger to take the palm rest off. Now you can grab the battery cable and disconnect it from the motherboard. We disconnect the battery to prevent any shortages to the motherboard or the LCD. Now you can disconnect the touchpad ribbon and the keyboard ribbon. I'm just going to put the palm rest back into place to prevent any scratching or damaging to the internal parts. Now for the LCD replacement, you want to take your spudger and take the bezel off. To get this LCD out of the top cover, you want to take some tweezers and find these black adhesive tabs. And once you get a hold of it, pull the adhesive tabs straight out. Make sure you don't pull up or down to prevent the LCD from breaking. You want to be extremely careful when removing the adhesive strips. They're kind of difficult to remove. You just want to be mindful that you're not pulling up on them, that you're pulling down, and try to pull around the unit. So once the strips are removed, you can take the LCD out and disconnect the LCD cable from the back of the LCD. Now grab your new LCD, start by flipping it over and reconnecting the LCD cable. Now you need to grab your adhesive strips and take one of them off. You want to make sure the white side is facing down and the blue side is facing up, and that the black tab is at the bottom of the screen, which, since it's flipped over, it would be on the same side as the LCD cable. You just want to grab your second adhesive strip and just do the same thing. And once you're done with that, you can take the top blue part of it and remove them. And then flip the LCD over and put it back into place. Now you can grab your bezel and put the bezel back on. To put the bezel back on, you might have to remove the hinge cover. And then put this part of the bezel back on. Cover on over top. Now you can take your spudger and take the palm rest back off. Now you want to grab your palm rest and reconnect the touchpad ribbon and the keyboard ribbon. Once those are reconnected, now you can reconnect the battery. And then put the palm rest back on. And then close the unit and put the bottom cover screws back in. To verify that the repair was successful, you can grab your AC adapter and plug the unit in. And then open the unit up. And if the unit turns on, that means the replacement was successful. And if you would like to check to see if the battery is working properly, you can just unplug the unit. And if it stays on while it is no longer plugged in, then that means the battery is working. So now you can shut the unit down.